Hi everyone, welcome you all. In the today's session, we are going to see some more important features from Postman and especially from admin and execution side, and we'll start. So in the Postman tool, in our previous sessions, we have created so many collections and we have seen how to send different type of HTTP requests, and we have seen response and we have done a lot of validations, right? So today we are going to see something called, let's say, how we can export and import collections. And sometimes we can, once you test your collections, we have to maintain these collections. So for that, we can have to export them. And whenever you need those collections to test, we can just import them in another Postman tool or in the same tool, right? So now we'll see how we can export and import collections. And to do this, we have different options are provided in Postman, and there are many ways to do that. So I'll show you one by one how we can export and import collections from Postman tool. Now let us start. So Postman, exporting and importing collections. So for that, let me just create one new collection, and on that collection we will see all the features. So let me just say new collection. Before that, let me show you the sample REST API. So we have a sample REST API. Let's say search for countries REST API. So now we can just see REST countries, and this is a sample demo APIs they have provided for testing, and you can use it further. So if I just come down, and there are API endpoints are available, I can just say come down here, and there are different API endpoints are provided, and they're also giving some URLs, and when I send this URL, we'll get some response. And basically these APIs are related to countries information. So it depends upon the country name, full name, code, list of codes, currency. Based on that information, we can get the country's information. So suppose if you want to get the country information based on the capital city, so you can just click on the capital city here, and this is the URL which you have to pass. And here we have to specify the capital of the country. So let me just maximize this page. So here, this is the URL which you have to send. And here we have to substitute some capital, let's say, if it is a India, so I have say New Delhi, so this will give you all the information about the India country. And similarly, when I say name here, so there is another API which is available, and here if I instead of name, you can just pass the country name, which will give you all the information about the country, like how many states, districts and currencies, all other information. So these are some sample APIs are provided. Now let us do some operations on these APIs. So I'm just going to take two different APIs on this. So first, I'm just taking the name and copy this URL, and I'm going to send that request here. So let's take a GET request, and I'm pasting that URL. And here we have to specify the name of the country. So for now, I'm just say India. So this is the name of the country, and then say send. So once you get the send the GET request, and now we got some result here. And all the country name and top level domain, alpha 2, alpha 3 code and capital and all other details we got here. Okay, and then once you got this data, so this is basically we got some response, and along with this, we also got some cookies and headers, and you can add later all the verification points under test app. So for now, I'm just adding this request. I'm saving this request into some different collection. So let me just create a new collection. And here the collection name is, I'll say countries API. Okay, or I'll say countries collection, API collection, countries API collection. And now I created one new collection. I'm just going to save this request under this collection. Now I can save, and I'm just going to select the collection name, which is countries API collection. I'm saving it. I'm just having the same name and say save. All right, so this is one API request I have sent, and similarly, I'll also take one more request and go back to the documentation here, REST API, and capital city. So let's take a capital city here, and this is the URL which we have to send. Copy this URL and go to the Postman, paste that URL, and here we have to pass the capital. I'll say Delhi, which is capital of India. I'll send. Now it will give you country name and other information related to the country. Right. So now I'm also going to save this collection, save this request under the collection, save under countries API collection, and select this. Let me select the countries API collection. Just a moment. Save. and here we have to take the collection name. So I said countries API collection and then save it. All right, so now I have a two requests which I have created under collection API. So these are the two requests, right? So let us try to run these two requests and click on this arrow and click on the run, and which will open a collection runner window. And from here you can execute. So we can just click on run collection API. Now both the requests are successfully sent and passed. So now I haven't put any verification points. Later you guys can add some verification points to this request. So now let us see some more operations on this collection. Let's say like execution and administrative level. Suppose I want to export and import these collections. So how to export and how many ways we can export and how many ways we can import the collections into Postman. So let us see what are the options we have. So here, this is a collection and I can export this collection as a file in the JSON format. And then also we can also import that collection as a file. So let me first, before importing, first we need to export this collection. So what I can do is I can just click on this three dots and you can find one option called export. And once you click on this export, it will show you three different options. And first one is deprecated and second one collection version 2 is available. And Postman is recommending collection version 2.1. So let it be this option and then say export. And this option is basically exporting your collection in the JSON format. I already exported earlier, so I'm just replacing with that. And save in the some folder. I have already created one folder called exported collections on my desktop and I have exporting this collection. Save and I'm replacing the old collection. So now I have exported my collection in the JSON format. So once we have exported your collection, and collection again contains a two requests. So along with the two requests, the collection, the entire collection will be exported. Now after exported this collection, I'm just going to delete this collection. How to delete this collection? Right click, or you can just say three dots and you can find something called delete. And if you don't find here, you can just right click on the collection and you can find delete here. And now I'm deleting the collection. So I don't have collection in my Postman now. I already exported as a file and which is available in my desktop as a JSON file. So now I want to import that file into my Postman tool. So import that file, what you can do is go to import button here, or else you can just go to the file or you can use import. Now, once you click on this import and you can see four different options, file or folder or link or raw text. So these are the different ways we can import the collection file. So we can import as a file, or we can import as a folder, or we can import as a link, or we can import as a raw text. These are different ways we can import the collection. So first we will see as a format of file. So again, in the file, we have a different format like open API format, RAML format, GraphQL format, curl format, and WDL format. So there are different formats are available. So select the file and upload files. And here, whichever collection we have uploaded into this folder previously, and we can just select that collection file in the JSON format and then save open. So now it is trying to import. So now we got the collection and say import. So once you have done this, collection countries API collection is imported. Now you can see the collection which contains a two request. So this is a one way we can export a collection as a JSON format of JSON format file, and then we can import the collection using file. So this is the option we have used. Right click, or we can say import. So we have say import, and here we have used this file option. This is one option we have. So other than this, we also have folder option. Sometimes this collection is saved in some folder. We can select that folder directly. So let me show you that option. So let me just delete this first. Right click on the collection, delete. Now again, I have deleted my collection. So this time I'm going to import the collection from the folder itself. So again, go to the import option. And here instead of file, I can select folder. Now here you can just drag and drop the folder, or you can choose folder from your computer. So click on this option. And currently from my desktop, this is my folder currently have. From this folder, I'm going to import my collection. So select the folder and select the folder. Click on select folder button. So now from that folder, the collection is imported, and say click on import button. Now still I got the countries API collection, which contains a two requests here. So this is another way to import the collection. So we can import the collection from the folder. And there is another way apart from the export. So when I do exporting, normally we are exporting as a JSON file. So which is there in our local system, right? So we can look, go to the desktop and I have saved the collection under my folder. So collection folder, let me just show you that. So I have just uploaded my collection and which is available under exported collection. So this is my collection which is exported on desktop. And this is a file in the form of file. And suppose if you want to share your collection to somebody else, so somebody want to execute your collection from their postman or some in remote environment. So you have it two ways. Either you have to share this collection file to the other people, or you can share a link. So from that link, they can import the collection in their environment or in their postman tool, and they can run the collection. Okay, so here I'll show you one more option to import. So let me also write it. The first option we have seen is exporting a collection, export collection as a file and also import as a file. And the second option, what we have seen is export a collection to a folder and import from the folder. Now what I'm going to do is I'm not exporting the collection as a file, but I want to share the collection and I will get the link first of all. And by using that link, I can import the collection. Okay. So let me show you the third option here. So when you're trying to import, we have other option called link. We have seen file and folder. Now this time I'm going to show you link. So to import the collection by using link, first of all, we have to share the collection and get the link. And by using that link, we can import. So first of all, let me share the collection to get the link. So here I already have a collection, countries API collection. Now I'm going to share it. Click on these three dots and click on the share collection. And here you can see three options: to workspace, embed, and get public link. So go to the third option, get public link. And here you can find one option called get a public link. Click on this button and then which will generate a link here. And this is a link everyone can access from their environment. So copy this link and you can close this. So now we have shared the collection. We have shared the collection and we have get the link, and then we can import that collection by using a link. So once we share the collection, we got this link now. So now by using this link, we can import the collection into Postman. So once we have exported, once we have shared this collection, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete the collection from my Postman. Say this, I'm just going to delete again. So now I want to import the collection by using link. So we already captured the link after exported, after shared. So now I'm going to use the same link to import the collection. So this time click on import. Now go to the link and here we have to specify the link. So basically these collections will be saved in under workspace, which is in the cloud environment of Postman tool. Now we have to use this link here and say continue, and this will import your collection from the cloud. So we can just select countries API collection, then say import. So now we have imported our collection successfully by using link. So this is one more option we have. So we have to share a collection, get the public link, then import that collection as a link. So where we have to specify the link. And this is a one way to do that. And there is one more way to do that. That is by using raw text. So when I click on the import button, in the third option, you can see raw text. We have so far, we have seen file, folder, link. Now I'm going to show you raw text. So when you click on the raw text here, we have to paste something called a curl syntax. So paste raw text. So here we have to pass something called curl text. So before that, we need to understand what is exactly curl means. So curl is nothing but a client URL, and which is basically a command line tool, which will be available on Windows and Mac or Linux in everywhere. And by using that command line tool, we can execute our HTTP request, or we can send all HTTP requests and we will get the response by using that particular tool. So that is basically called as a curl.
So before using this curl in the Postman tool, let me just give you some information. So let's go to command prompt on Windows. And if I just by default, curl will be there. It is a client component or CLI component from where we can send our request, we can get the response. And whatever we can do on the Postman tool, like get, post, delete all the requests, HTTP requests, we can do the same thing using command line. So to do that, curl is a command line tool which is provided and which is by default will be there on Windows as well as Linux and Mac, we can use it. So how we will know whether it is there or not, we can just say open the command prompt and then say curl --version, and this will give you the curl version which is available on Windows. And by using this curl command, we can provide all the URLs along with the headers and other API keys and everything. And we can use this command line window to test our REST APIs, HTTP request. Okay, so this is a basic understanding what exactly curl is. So here, whenever you're trying to import a collection, in the RAD text, we have to provide the client URL. So along with the command, we have to specify the client URL. So by using that client URL, we can import the collection. And sometimes when you read any API documentation online, you will see the curl URLs. So let me just show you some example, then you can understand what exactly curl is. Even some documentation is also will be written in the curl language. So let me, I have some documentation link here, and which is a sample document which is provided by Postman itself. And this is basically cat API live. And if I just look at this API documentation, apart from this URLs, they will also provide something called curl links here. So this is a curl, and which contains some option, like this is a URL get request. Let me increase the size. So you can see this is a get request URL and headers API key, which we can pass along with the request. And similarly, we can also send the post request, put request and all other HTTP request. So this is a basically command line tool where we can test our REST APIs or where we can send our request by using curl. Okay. Now, by using this curl, we can import the APIs or we can import the collections into our Postman tool. Now, I'll show you a small example here how we can import. So for example, here I have a different APIs images, and under images, we have a different get request we have, right? So what I can do is I just want to copy some curl information here from this document. Let us say copy this information curl. And then I'll paste over here. So go to directly import and go to raw text. And here I'm passing that curl information. And once you pass this information, so here, once you pass this information, just we need to click on continue. And now it is imported the request. So we can just say import. So now we can see that is imported. So you can see get request, and later you can save it under the collection. So I can just click on the save, and whichever in whichever collection you want to save that request, you can clearly save it. So this is a another way to import REST APIs based upon the curl URL or curl command line. So every time, most of the times you can see the API documentation, and most of the times you can see the curl URLs along with the REST API request. So by using this curl also, we can import your request and collections into your Postman tool. So that is another option also available. So these are four different type of imports. We have file, folder, link, and raw text. Okay. And sometimes if your curl is representing the complete collection, not to specific request, then the entire collection will be imported. Okay. So this is, these are the different export and import options which are available in collection. And once you exported, you got some link, right? So by using that link, you can execute your Postman or you can import your collection in anywhere. So suppose if you want to run that collection somewhere in Jenkins or some any third party tool, you can use that shared link. Everyone can access your collection by using that link. Okay, so these are all different import options are available. So the last option will be import as a raw text. Here we have to specify the curl command and then say import. So by using these four options, we can export and import collections into our Postman tool. So after that, we will see something called, suppose I have created one collection which contains a number of APIs. So I want to make a small documentation on this. So to represent others. So I want to specify what is my collection name, what are the different requests I have sent, and in detail, like what is the request type, what are the parameters I have to pass, a description, and everything I want to make it as a small document. And then I want to share the document to somebody else. So how we can prepare API documentation, or how we can publish the document on the Postman cloud. And anybody can access the document if I pass that URL. Okay, so now how we can make that small document for this particular API or collection. So for that, what you have to do is you can just click on the three dots on the collection, and you will find something called publish docs. Okay, you can find this option called public docs, and I have selected the collection. Click on the three dots, and then you can see something called public docs. So once you click on publish docs, so once you click on this publish docs, and then it will open another URL, and everything will be saved under Postman cloud environment under your workspace. So here publishing your collection in the form of a document. So you can just provide what is the version of collection and current version. And if there is environment, you can select that environment, and other URL and styling information you can select from this document, and colors and everything you can select. And once you added all this information, it is just a look and feel of your document. And once you provided all the information, and then you can just publish collection. So once you click on the public collection, which is created a new document, collection is published successfully. And if anybody want to access the documentation of your collection API, then you can just open this URL. So let me open this URL on another link. Just a moment, right click, or you can just copy this URL and put that URL in another browser page. So now we can see whatever the collection you have uploaded as a document. Now we can see the clear documentation. So I have not provided an environment or layout anything at the time of creating the document. So it is not giving any details here, but apart from this, you can see the documentations here. So introduction. So there are two requests we have, and for get request, this is a URL, and this is a URL we have to send. And it is also automatically generated the curl. So by using this curl also, you can import this request into your Postman tool. Okay, if you have a more number of requests, it will be very, very attractive. So let me just create one more document for our collections. Let's go to Postman, and let me just take another collection which is having more number of requests. Okay, so let me just take something called fake API. So this is a sample API I have, which contains a different type of request and two different get requests, one post request, put and delete request. So let me create one small document on this collection. So again, click on these three dots, and you will get publish docs. And once you click on the publish docs, and here you can see, and all other information you can just provide here. And then you can say publish collection. So now it is created. Now let me open this URL. And if I share this URL to anyone, so they can access a document of this collection. Now we can see, so there are different collections I have. So get users, get single user, post user. These are the different names of request. And this is a collection name. And now you can see these are the collection URLs I have mentioned. And along with this, if there is a post request, what is the body we have to send also provided here. And especially for put request also, and delete request. And along with this, you can also see some curl information, and by which you can also import this API request into your Postman tool. So this is a very good documentation in very detail. All detail information will be available in this documentation, right? So this is a way we can create a small documentation for your collections or APIs from your Postman itself. And you can share this documentation with your team. Right, so this is another important and very good feature which is available in Postman tool. So that is all about documenting collections. Okay, and now we'll see one more last topic. Suppose we have exported some collections, or we have shared some collections. If we exported a collection, we got some JSON file or exported file. Or suppose if I share a collection, we got a link, right? So now if I have some exported collection file or if I have a link, suppose I want to run them remotely. So, or I want to run them through command prompt. So how we can run without using Postman tool? I want to run them in the command prompt. And later I want to run those in third party, like a continuous integration tool like Jenkins. So how we can do that? So let me show you some run options. How many ways we can run the collections? So the first thing is we can directly run the collection into Postman tool itself, right? And suppose if I want to run this collection, let me just go back to the countries. And here, countries API collection. So if you want to run all the requests from this collection, normally what we will do is we'll click on the three dots, or we can go with that runner. And here it will open the window, and here we can select the which collection we want to run. Suppose I want to run countries API collection, which will display two requests which are already available in this collection. We can select the environment, number of iterations, and time and all, and then click on the run countries API. And within the Postman itself, we can run the multiple requests, or we can run single collection at a time. So here we can see all the data and everything, and we can also export the result. Once you click on export a result, and results also we can export it in the form of JSON file. So this is one option we have within the Postman tool, and this is a one way to execute your collection and within the Postman using runner window, right? And there is one more option. Suppose to execute your collection within the command prompt without using your Postman tool, we can still do that. And we can execute your collection in the command prompt again by using either link or collection file. So let me show you the second way. Run your collection or run collection in the command prompt or command prompt or in the CLI mode. Okay, so here to run the collection in the command prompt or in the CLI mode, we need to have either uploaded collection file. We have to export the collection first. Export collection file in JSON file as a JSON format. This is one thing we should have. Or we should also have, we can also have, once you share your collection, right, we'll get a link. Even we should have that link. Shared collection link. So at least we need to have either exported file of the collection, or at least we should have a shared collection link. If you have at least one of them, we can run our collection in the command prompt. Okay, so now I'll show you both the ways how we can do this. The first one is we have to export a collection, and then we will run that collection file through command prompt. And if you want to do these things, as a prerequisite, we have to install Node.js. And I already discussed this in my previous Postman videos. You can just go through them. I'll provide the link in my description. So first we need to install Node.js. And once you install Node.js, you will get NPM component by default. And by using NPM component, you have to install NPM install Newman. So this is a new component which you have to install to run your collections through command prompt. So how to install Node.js, NPM, and Newman, I have already shown you in my previous Postman videos, and please go through them. So these are the prerequisites we need to have to run your collection through command prompt. Okay, so I already have them in my system. If you want to cross check, just go to the command prompt, and here you can just check the command. I'll say Node.js -- version, and I think this is not giving Node.js. Okay, I think just a node command we have to give. Yeah, so when I say node -- version, this will give you what is the Node.js currently installed in my system. And similarly, if I just say npm -- version, and this will give you which version of npm which is installed on my system. So by default, npm will come along with the Node.js. So you no need to install npm separately, so which will come along with the Node.js. So now it is also displayed npm version. And top of npm, by using npm version, we have to use Newman. So Newman is also available. If you want to check, I'll say Newman --version. And this will also display the Newman. So once you have installed Node and NPM, then you can install Newman on top of NPM. And then you are ready to execute your collections through command prompt. This is most important prerequisite. All right, so now I have all three. So now I'm just going to use this Newman to run my collection. And first of all, I already exported my collection, so I can run that collection. And then I will show you how to execute your collection through shared link. Now, let me just go to my Postman. First of all, let me export this collection. So how to export this country's API collection? I can just click on three dots. And first I'll show you export as a file, then I'll show you share collection. So export this collection as a file, click on this collection 2.1 as a export. Now we already exported earlier, I'm just replacing it. Exported collections folder, and I'm exporting this collection. I'm replacing which is already there. Okay, now I have exported my collection. So now I want to run that collection file without using Postman tool. I want to run the collection, exported collection through my command prompt. Okay, so how we can run it? So let me just again open my command prompt. And we can just close this window. I'll open another command prompt, cmd. Okay, so let me increase a font in my command window. So to do this, I'll just say properties and font size. I can just make it 24. I'll say okay. So now I have just increased my font size in my command prompt. Okay, so now let us try to run our collection file through my command prompt. So first of all, let's get the path of your collection. So where I have stored on my desktop and collections folder, exported collections. This is my folder, exported collection. Under this, my file is present. So let us copy this location. And what is the command we have to give is, let me just write the command first. So the command is, we have to say newman -run, or can say simply newman run, and then say location C:\users/, and the collection name also we have to specify. Copy the collection name and then we need to specify. So this is a command we have to execute, newman run and the location of your collection. Now let us copy this and then execute through command prompt. Now I'm pasting over here. If not, let me just paste properly. Okay, now I have pasted on my command window and then I'm running my collection through command window using Newman. So now it is successfully executed. I have two requests inside my collection and both have executed and there is no errors we found. And if you add any validation points, you can find how many got passed, how many are failed, all that information. So I'm able to execute my collection successfully through command prompt. So this is a one way to do this. If you have a exported collection file in JSON format, you can use this command to run your collection through command prompt. Suppose if you have shared your collection and get the link, and using that link also you can run your collection. I will show you this option now. Go to your Postman and share the collection. So right click on three dots, or you can just click on the right three dots and share collections. And once you share collections, go to get public link, and here get the public link. Click on the get public link. Now we got the link here. And you can share this link with your team and anyone can run your collection from their remote machines. And copy this link. And now how to run that collection using that link? Again, the same command, newman run, and instead of specifying the exported file location, this time we have to specify the location or link of your collection. So now let us run this command through command prompt. Let me just clear it, then copy the command, enter. So this time your collection is going to run by using link, shared link. So now it is successfully executed. Okay, so these are the two different options we have to run your collections through command prompt. Okay, and once it is successful, we should also able to run our collections through continuous integration tools. So let us say Jenkins. So Jenkins is very popular and well-established CI tool, which is available in the market. Now I'll show you how we can run your collections through Jenkins. And again, there also, we can run your collection file through your collection JSON format file, or by using link also, we can run your collection within your Jenkins. Okay. So now let me just show you how we can run your Jenkins. Let me copy this notes. I'll say Postman session 7. Okay. So now I'm going to show you how to run your collections through Jenkins. So Jenkins is a basically continuous integration tool. So if I just look at here, Google Chrome, and type Jenkins. And this is Jenkins official website. And if you want to install Jenkins, and you can just go to download. And here, just for practice purpose, you can just download a generic package. And if you are working on Windows or any other operating system, this generic package will work, generic Java package. And you can also install Jenkins through installer. You can just download the complete installer and you can install, or else you can just get this WAR file. And whenever you want to work with the Jenkins, you can just run this WAR file and it will start Jenkins. And this is for just practicing purpose. And if you want to really work with the Jenkins for the long time, you can just go with this standalone installation. So once you click on this WAR file, it will just download generic Java package WAR file. And whenever you want to work with the Jenkins, you can just run the WAR file. So you already have it. Let me just cancel. So once you get this WAR file of Jenkins, you can just keep that WAR file somewhere in your system. So currently I have that WAR file under C drive. And here I have a Jenkins folder. And here I have kept my WAR file, jenkins.var. So whenever you want to work with the Jenkins, you can just run this WAR file, and which will start your Jenkins on the Tomcat server. So now I'll show you how to start your Jenkins. And first time when you're starting your WAR file, you need to do some settings, like you need to authenticate Jenkins by passing administrator password. And then you have to add some default plugins, and then you have to create your own login information. All these things will be there. So I have explained in detail how to install Jenkins and all in my previous videos. And you can just get this. I will provide the links also in my description. You can go through and watch those videos, and then you will understand how to install and work with the Jenkins. So for now I have a WAR file. So I want to just run the WAR file to invoke my Jenkins application. So for that, you have to just open the command prompt. And in this command prompt, so currently my WAR file is present here itself. So here I'll give one command, java-jar and jenkins.var. So when you run this command first time, so it will give you some administrator secrets password in the console window. You have to search for it in the console window itself. And once you provided that password only, it will open the Jenkins. Later you can do some configurations, but I already done it multiple times, so it will not ask you for me. So it is directly starting my Jenkins. So let's wait for a few seconds. Still you get this message like Jenkins is fully up and running. And once it is started, then you can minimize this window. Don't close this window. So till you complete your work on Jenkins, this window should be open. So minimize this window and now go to the browser. And here by default, Jenkins will run on this localhost :8080 port number. So now I have started my Jenkins, and let's wait for a few seconds to start my Jenkins. It takes a few seconds of time to start my Jenkins. It is saying Jenkins is full up and running, but it still takes a few seconds of time. Let me write one more time, localhost 8080. So let's wait for a few seconds, then it will launch my Jenkins. Okay, so now I have successfully opened my Jenkins application. So already I logged in multiple times, so it is successfully logged into my Jenkins. So first time when you open your Jenkins, it will ask you the credentials, login and password. And once you provide it, you will able to log in into Jenkins. All right, so now I have Jenkins application. So now I will show you how to run your collection through your Jenkins. Okay, So again, you can run the collection file in Jenkins, or you can use this URL to run your collection in the Jenkins. Now I'll show you both. So first of all, let me just create a new item. So click on the new item, and then here we have to give some project name. So here I'll say Postman Countries API. Okay, this is some project name you have to give. And after that, I'll just select freestyle project. So here freestyle project is enough. We don't need to go for Maven or Pipeline or any other projects. So select the freestyle project and then say, okay. So once you said okay, so then it will go to configuration page. Right, so now here you can just write some description and you don't need to select any options here, and directly come to build section. And here, so currently we are on Windows, so we have to use execute Windows batch command. Or if you are working on any Linux or any other operating system, you have to use execute shell. So let me just select execute Windows batch command, and here you have to provide the command, Newman command we have to provide. So this is the same command we have to provide to run your collection through Jenkins. So currently this particular file is available in my local machine. So the Jenkins also will get the JSON file from my local machine itself. So once you've given this command, just say apply and save. Once you save this, now it will go to project specific dashboard. So from here, you can click on build now, then it will start running your collection. Let me just click on the build now. So once you click on the build now, it is started. Now click on this progress bar, and then your country's API successfully executed, because we have only two requests and it is very faster and it is executed very soon. And one more thing you can just notice here, sometimes when you run your collections through Newman command, you will see some Unicode characters in your Jenkins. Okay, so most of the people will commonly see this. And to avoid this, what we can do is we can just give some command. Let me just go to back to project, and you can just go to again configure, and this will go to again your configuration page. So here we have given this command, right? So when you run this command, Newman run and collection, before providing this, I can just provide you one option to avoid Unicode characters. For that, what you can do is --, you have to disable them. I say disable --Unicode. Disable --Unicode. So --, disable --Unicode, and then provide the location of your collection. So this option will remove the Unicode characters. And then again, apply and save. And again, go back to your project specific page. And then again, one more time, build now. We already run one time, so this is our second round. Click on build now. So once you click on the build now, again, it will start second round of execution. It is very faster, execute and pass. So this time we don't see any Unicode characters and everything executed successfully. So one more time, I'm going to run. Click on build now. And once you click on the build now, it is started execution. Click on the progress bar. Now here everything is successfully completed. So we don't see any Unicode characters. So this is how we can execute our collection file through your Jenkins. And sometimes we can also execute our collection through link. So this link also we can use within your Jenkins. So for that, what you can do is just go to your Jenkins once again. Back to your project. You can create any new project, or else you can just modify the existing project. So go to configure, and it will go to configuration page once again. And previously we have given the collection file location or path, which is there in your local system. Suppose I want to provide the link here. So I already shared my collection. I got the link. So I'm just going to provide this link, and then I can run the collection. Instead of providing the location or file path, I just say link here. And rest of the command is exactly the same. Newman run disable Unicode. Let me increase the size. Okay, so Newman run --, disable Unicode, and just provide the collection. And this is a collection URL, not a collection file. And after that, you can just say apply and save, and then click on build now. So this time it will run your project using your link. So now you can see it is successfully executed. So it is very faster because we have only two requests and we don't even have the validation points. So if you have a more number of requests, if you have a more number of validation points, it takes some time to complete execution. And it will also show you how many are executed, how many passed, how many failed, all the information will be populated here. Okay, so this is how we can run our collections in Jenkins by using a collection file, exported a collection file or global link. So this link we can use to access your collection from anywhere. So these are all different run options which are available in Postman to execute your collections within the Postman. And we can execute your collections through command prompt, and we can also execute our collection within the Jenkins. So these are all available run options in the Postman. Okay, so that's all for this session, guys. We have seen how to export and import different type of collections, how many ways we can export and import. Then we have seen how to document your collection. And finally, we have seen how to run your collection in different ways within the Postman, in the command prompt, and within the Jenkins. Okay, so that's all for this session. Thanks for watching. Bye.